What's up, YouTube? I am back with another video, and as you can see, I have a new mask again. Every mask that I get from my jobs, I'm gonna use to make a new video with. Today's video is about Cream of Wheat and Uncle Ben's wife looking, reviewing their product to change their local logo after catching backlash on Twitter. Yeah, let me repeat that one more time. Cream of Wheat and Uncle Ben's rice is reviewing their product to think of ways to better it since they came since they got backlash on Twitter. This decision, Cream of Wheat. Cream of Wheat has a brand of Cream of Wheat and oatmeal with a black chef on the front and a chef uniform. And Uncle Ben's rice has a picture of a black man in the front, and a lot of people on Twitter is saying that it has racism organs. And I took the time to read the article from my understanding. That's basically what they're saying. I don't see any racism organs behind it. I see that black people did more for the country than what we know about. You know, black people are part of a lot of things in the country, but America don't want to give us credit for it. That's what I see. In my opinion, that's what I see. You know, maybe it is true that a lot of good food is made based on black people. You know, that black people helped create it. We never know. But I don't feel that it's racist in any way, having a black man on the front. You know, but this comes after the Aunt Jemima and the Buttermilk Autumn. I mean, all these brands is now up for review. The company's reviewing it because the main reason they don't want to lose money from having a black person on the front. And they don't want no issue with racism and all that whatnot. So they doing a review of everything to basically take it away, get rid of it. You know, I think that's crazy in my head because now this can get blown out of proportion. You know, this can get blown out of proportion because now it can really do turn into a bit racist issue because just like the old brand, the Uncle Ben has a black man in front of the rice box. The Icon Cream of Wheat has a black chef on the front. The buttermilk syrup bottle is shaped like a black woman. The Aunt Jemima is a black woman on the front. You know, all the products with a black woman, black person on the front, they're trying to get rid of, but how it can turn into a bigger issue because now someone can go online or social media and say they feel something racist behind KFC. KFC, why do the colonel have to be a white man? You know what I mean? I'm just saying, for example, I'm not racist, no way. I was adopted by a white woman growing up, you know, that was completely hood. So don't take it that I'm being racist because there's not a racist bone in my body, but I'm just saying, for example, I'm just giving examples of how it could turn into a racism issue in America because like Wendy's, the Wendy's girl, why do we have to be a white girl with freckles in her face? You know? This is how things can get blown out of proportion, for example, as I said again. Also, Ronald McDonald. Why do they have to be a white clown? See, it's a lot of things can be taken as racism. So don't just look at it as just a black thing. You know, there's a lot of things in America that has a white logo that can be taken racist, just like everything with a black logo, with a black person on it, can be taken racist with certain people in America. You know what I mean? And also, I did a little research before doing this video, as you can see. Every article concerning this, all these brands with a black image on it that they want to change all of a sudden after hundreds of years old. I also know that when you click on the links and go to the Twitter and see the accounts of these people that are making the comments and talking on it, it's mainly all black people. It's mainly all black people that sound illiterate. If you read the comments on their Twitter posts, they sound illiterate. They sound illiterate. So that tell you they don't have no education. And it's a young generation. It's the young generation, not the older generation. You know what I mean? These people just now coming to the fire don't know nothing about black American history. You know what I'm saying? But that's just my opinion, not to get off topic. But I don't see nothing racist about it. It's good to see some brands with black people on it. You know what I mean? It's good to see some things that black people invented, you know, and inspired companies with millions to put a black person on the brand. That's something good that I feel should not be taken away. I feel like it's been living on for over 100 some years. I say let that history continue to live on. That's what I say. Don't change y'all brand. Take that backfire somewhere and make your money. Collect the money, because that's all they're going to do is make that brand sell more. That make the cream and wheat, the Uncle Ben's rice, and the syrup, the buttermilk bottle syrup, shit like a big girl. That gonna make all them products sell even more. None is catching all this backfire, all this heat. So let it stay. Let the black people have our shine, man. That's what I gotta say to America. Let the black community have they shine. We just as positive as any other race. We just as positive in the world as any other race. It's nothing racist about them images, you know? That's just what probably a black person inspired them to make that image, to put that image on that product, you know? It haven't been a problem for all the year, and all of a sudden, everything is a problem. You know what I mean? Well, that problem can get blown out of proportion. But I say to those companies, don't make no changes. Don't make no changes needed. Don't make no changes needed. No changes needed. Continue it with your product. Keep it the way that it is and collect that check, because that check gonna really come in now. That check gonna really come in behind all this racism nonsense. That's just gonna make people go out and buy more. Now, if you do change the image on it, that might hurt your sales. That might make people don't want to buy no more of your product. Quaker Oats, you know, you is a big brand in the world. Also with that, why they ain't coming as an issue? Quaker Oats has a white man in front of their product. Why is that not being taken racist? Please tell me, all those Twitter gangsters, please share it with us. Why Quaker Oats had a white man on the front of their product? Why that's not racist? Why not a big thing about that being racist come up? Please share it with us. Please share it with me. I hope some of them big famous people on Twitter or big names on Twitter to get these big tweets, they tweets getting heard. I hope y'all come across my video. That's why I want to be a big platform. That's why I want my platform to grow. That's why I want my platform to grow as big as it can, because there's a lot of good topics out here that a nice lower class person like me can speak on and share a lot of light on. You know what I mean? So that's why I want to get my platform as big as I can. So y'all do whatever in your power to help this platform grow. I know I have a good channel, but I need the right supporters. I need more genius supporters to really get my views up there. Where I can get heard and seen by other people in power, getting big views and whatnot on YouTube. You know what I mean? Because we need a voice. The lower class people need a voice, and I want to be that voice. I want to be that voice, because I feel this need to stop. You know, because this can get blown out of proportion. They can get taken all kind of ways, and that's how I'm taking it. You know, if you're gonna shout racism on every black image you see in America, shout racism on every white image you see on product. Every Puerto Rican, every Haitian, Jamaican, every symbol product you see with a person on it that resembles a nationality, any kind of nationality, once y'all turn that into a race issue, why it gotta be a black thing, you know? Don't be racist against something, be racist against everything. Don't call one chicken a racist issue and not turn everything else into a racist issue, you know? But take the time to go check those tweets out. You gonna see, I don't recognize none of them people. None of them people that's talking about the issue. I don't see nothing racist, you know. I take those brands that a lot of black people did a lot of good about it. Like the King vitamin cereal. Why does it have to be a white king on that vitamin cereal? You know what I mean? Why did that character of a king have to be white? But nobody making a big deal about them. So let these black images be the same way. Let those black images live on. Let those black images live on like you let all the like America let all the white images live on. That's what I have to say. That's my opinion and my thoughts on this. It's not nothing racist about it whatsoever. It's just a lot of black people back then was very inspiring. They're like how y'all look up to Michael Jordan and all this other nonsense in the world. Same thing with all these brands that have a black image on the front. Something about that company they seen that they inspired them to make that image. Let it live on to the world end. You know, let it live on to the world end, because it's nothing racist about it. I'm pretty sure those companies had racist intentions. I'm pretty sure they did. It was inspired to do something positive and wanted to do it. And hey, supposedly those brands that they got the black person on, that was the ones that created their image and didn't have the money to make it a reality. So that bigger brand made it a reality for them. You know, because that is something that's done all the time. Disney do the same thing. If you give Disney an idea for a movie or for something, they have you sign everything over to them, And you're not missing them, you're not missing no more. They take and make a big old profit from it while you get nothing. You know what I mean? While you watch your dream, somebody else make a reality. That could have been what it was back then. You know what I mean? All them black, a lot of black people had big ideas, but they lacked the money. They lacked the money to make it a reality. But new other people, white and whatever the case may be, they had the money, they could make their dream a reality and made it a reality. How many people you know in America that has nice recipes and nice barbecue sauce that you can't find in stores, but they use it at home? You know what I mean? It's like that because they don't have that money. They don't have the kind of money needed to make this product big to get that product out there. Everything don't have to be a racist issue. Everything is not something racist with a colored face, with a black African American press on it. It's like, it's getting crazy. This is going to get real out of hand. So everybody take the time to really read this article and really go look at those images. I don't see nothing racist about them. I don't see nothing racist about them. If they were slaves, I haven't found nothing on it yet. There's some new people going around with the mama, the Auntie Jemima, her with a chain on her foot. I mean, I don't know how old that image is, but I still say, let it be said. So what, a slave is what led to America creating a brand behind her. You know what I mean? That way, that would help her live a luxurious lifestyle, live a good life. Was that Auntie Jemima pancake mix and syrup. So let that history live on. Let that history live on. That's what I have to say to this topic. Those my thoughts. Y'all tell me in the comments for a shout-out, my shout-out video the last Sunday in June. I'll be giving you a shout-out. If you don't, and if you like this video, remember to subscribe, like, comment, and share. Most importantly, if you don't like this video, take the time to go through my 21 playlist. I'm sure in one of them playlists, you will find a video that you like. If you like that video, remember to subscribe, like, comment, and share. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Enjoy y'all day.